Hello friends, welcome back to my channel English with Shyam sir and welcome to the Hindu paper editorial analysis. And you're watching the video about the editorial that came on June 16th. And I'm talking about a very important editorial article that came on the Hindu paper today. And the headline says, Bulldozer on the Loose. Bulldozer on the Loose. And in this video, I'll be talking in English, explaining the article and giving you the overall analysis. And remember, my dear friends, once the video is done, once you understand the explanation part from my side, my request is to read the same article again. For that purpose, I will also share the same editorial article that I'm explaining here, the soft copy, on our Telegram channel, and also I'll try to upload the same in the description as well. So without further delay, let's get started. Listen very carefully, my dear friends. This is a very interesting article, an important article. Before I get into the content of the article, I have to tell you that there are around 8 to 10 vocabulary in the article which are important for you to underline and understand them. Because only when you understand these words, it becomes easier for you to understand the article. If possible, I'll try to mention the list of the vocabulary also in the description as well. Right. So before I get into this article, I will make it very easy for you. I will have to give you some background. I will have to let you know some background story of this. My dear friends, it has become a very unfortunate process in our country for the last few years to see that governments which are in the power are misusing the power. For the fact that some governments in some states in the country, as they have the power with them, as they are the authority, they are, for some or the other reason, good or the bad reason, right at the wrong reason, government is directly dismantling the houses or the buildings of some people using the bulldozer. That is the reason why the headline says bulldozer on the loose. So governments are trying to demolish the houses or the buildings of some people using the bulldozers. Now the fundamental question is, generally this process will happen giving the prior notice of the person concerned, telling the person that we are demolishing this building and you have to vacate this building, and usually a notice will be sent to the owner of the property. Generally a notice will be sent to the owner of the property. This is a very fundamental thing, no doubt about it. In this scenario, there is a very recent incident that happened, as you already know. There is a person named Nupur Sharma. Nupur Sharma is the spokesperson of BJP, recently passed some remarks against, offensive remarks against the prophet, who is considered who is very much respected by the people of one particular religion. So that is the basic provocative step where many people started protesting against his remarks. Now the government is trying to demolish and dismantle the houses and the buildings of the people who are protesting against Nupur Sharma. So this is what the article is all about. To put it very, very briefly, government is trying to demolish and dismantle the buildings of some people who are actually agitating for justice, who are revolting against the remarks passed by Nupur Sharma, who actually passed remarks against prophet of a religion. This is what the fundamental point of the article. Now my dear friends, if you understand this article, five simple points mentioned in this article. Point number one is, in India, this bulldozer demolishing style of governance has become unfortunately very common in some states like Uttar Pradesh, Delhi, Kanpur and other states as well. Number one. Number two, my dear friends, the article has clearly said that this is nothing else but a mere retribution act. What is retribution? taking revenge. You troubled me, so I want to trouble you. And also in this article, it is very clearly mentioned that collective punishment, there is a vocabulary used, there is a term used in the article called collective punishment. So my dear friends, what is this collective punishment? The government is trying to attack people as a part of collective punishment by demolishing the houses. Generally, the houses or the buildings will be demolished when that particular building or the house is a part of encroachment. Do you know what encroachment is? Illegal occupation of something. So during encroachment, government has the absolute authority to dismantle the building, that too with a prior notice. But unfortunately, the buildings which are being dismantled by some governments, they are not encroached things, number one. Number two, have the notices been issued to the owners of the property? No. The notices also have not been issued. Straight away you go with a bulldozer, dismantle and demolish a building, indirectly giving the person concerned the warning that don't fight with me, I am more powerful than you. In this regard, in the article that I am talking about, there is a very interesting thing that is mentioned. Actually, this particular issue started with demolishing the residence, the house of a person named Javed Mohammed. So there is a person named Javed Mohammed. Who is this Javed Mohammed? He is the activist of Welfare Party of India. He is not the owner of the residence. The owner is his wife. The property, the residence, the house is under the name of his wife. But the notice has been sent to this person. The notice has not been sent to the actual owner, which is definitely not legal. Without sending the notice to the actual owner, you can't take any action like demolition. That is mistake number one. Mistake number two is, my dear friends, the notice has actually been sent just one day prior, it seems. But misusing the power, the notice is actually, the date in the notice is actually backdated. Which means, for example, today I'm talking on June 16th with you. Imagine yesterday the incident happened, that was June 15th. And the notice actually was sent on June 13th. But misusing the power in the notice, the date was backdated to almost like May. So now when the people are questioning, the authorities are saying, what can we do, sir? We have already sent you notice in the month of May, which is not actually legitimate. No doubt it is an illegitimate action at any cost. So generally, before we dismantle or demolish a building, there is some due process required. Like for example, when you send a notice to the person concerned that next month we are demolishing the building, so please vacate the building, they will vacate with all the items and the furniture, number one. Number two, they will have to also search another place, rehabilitate to a better place, correct? Without all these things, without being, you know, without following the due process, straight away you go and demolish a building is definitely a painful and a surprising, saddening part from the government side. So these are the important points mentioned in the article. So if you read this article, my dear friends, you can definitely understand, provided you know the background basically, and also you underline some vocabulary. So whatever I have said, I will end the video by recapitulating the points very briefly. Point number one, the actual story started like there is a man who belongs to BJP who passed some remarks against the another religion, and there in one way religious rivalry is being provoked, number one. And recently an activist who is protesting against this, his house is demolished without following the due process of sending a notice and even following the legal process, number two. Number three, the notice is sent not in the name of the owner, it is sent in the name of the wife of the owner, which is not a legitimate act. Number four, as per the article, it is written that retribution, collective punishment, not good. But unfortunately, retribution and collective punishment is what is actually the agenda behind this demolishing and dismantling and threatening the people using power or misusing power. And also, my dear friends, as the headline says, bulldozer on the loose, the basic question being put forward through this article is, this has now become a big challenge to the rule of the law, my dear friends. There is something called rule of the law, equality of the law. There is a due process to do anything. Without following any legitimate process, you have the power, you directly go with a big vehicle and you dismantle the building just for the fact that the person of that building acted against you or questioned you, definitely surprises a common man like you and I. So definitely this is not a democratic process. This is definitely an anti-democratic process. At the end of the day, whether be it Nupur Sharma or any other person, see whether that person has really passed the remarks. If so, what remarks is out of box, out of our necessity. But anybody who provokes religious rivalry, who incites religious disharmony, should be condemned. Because India is a beautiful nation with multi-diversity and a wonderful democracy which has to be preserved by everybody, including you and I. No doubt, nobody should be encouraged and welcomed when he or she is trying to disturb the peace and harmony in the country. Be it a common man or a rich man or a Muslim, Hindu, Christian or even a government servant or chief minister or even prime minister. Everybody is equal before the law. That is why we use the word equality before the law. And last but not the least, my dear friends, in this video, in this article, there is a line which I wanted to share with you, that is, this action of dismantling and demolishing the buildings without following the due process of sending the notice is nothing less than perpetrated resolve to keep minorities under check. I repeat, you read the article, you will find the same line. This action of demolishing the buildings without proper legal procedures is nothing less than perpetrated resolve to keep the minorities under check. Means what? Perpetrated resolve means a deliberate intentional act. To keep the minorities under check means to suppress the minorities or to threaten the minorities because you have the power with you. Definitely it is a condemnable gesture, condemnable act. So my dear friends, this is a beautiful article, not just as a content is important, but the language which is used in the article is very, very, very interesting. I thoroughly enjoyed reading this article. I was actually trying to add more related points to this article, but still I would like to wind off this. And my dear friends, like I have said, there are beautiful vocabulary present in the article, like retribution is one beautiful vocabulary, my dear friends, and collective punishment is another beautiful vocabulary. Then there is, I think I can share with you around 9 to 10 beautiful words, like you already know what encroachment is. Okay, like this, my dear friends, there is another beautiful vocabulary called fig leaf. Fig leaf means something done to hide something. Okay, fig leaf means to hide something, you do something, that's called fig leaf. Anyways, in India, this kind of gestures should definitely not encourage, should definitely be not encouraged. Let's hope and believe that the coming generations will have beautiful, beautiful India soon. So I enjoyed this article, my dear friends. I tried to explain this article as much as possible from my side. I want you now to read this article with a pen or a pencil in your hand, underline the beautiful vocabulary and study the article again. And I'm sure you will understand the article much better. I'm sure you do it on a regular basis. Your comprehending ability is going to improve so well. Read now. I will share the soft copy of the article with you. If you have any queries, any suggestions, you're welcome to send them on the message that is comment section. I'll meet you in my next daily editorial analysis. My dear friends, if somebody wants to watch this video, explanation of the analysis, I mean analysis and explanation of this article in Telugu, like you already know, you can keep tuned to my Telugu channel, that is Shyam Sir Cognizance, in which I am going to explain this in Telugu. Good luck and read the article. All the best.